Good morning everyone. So today we are discussing about modular load transmission system and brakes. So what are the slippers that is transmission system? So in the transmission system means different types of it will contains about clutch and gearing system. Together it is called as transmission system. So in the transmission system we have different types of clutches and its working principle and its construction methods. All those things will come into picture. Clutches, different types. Then we have the gearbox. Gearbox, different types of gearing mechanism, that is manual or automatic or semi-automatic, and gear shifting mechanism, then overdrive, fluid flywheel, torque converter, propeller shaft, inertial joint, differential and rear axle, then driving system, that is Hotchkiss drive and torque taper drive. So this is about transmission system. This is very lengthy module when compared to other modules. Braking system, that is also comes under this module. In the braking system we have types of brakes, then mechanical compressed air, vacuum hydraulic braking systems, then working of master and cylinder mechanisms, then brake shoe arrangement, disc brakes, anti-lock braking system, drum brakes. So different types of braking system are also involved in this module. So ABS purpose, always nowadays we are using ABS system, so you should know the operation and purpose of this ABS system. So first we will start about transmission system. So in the transmission system, what it will contains actually. So in the transmission system, that may use clutch, gearbox or propeller shaft and differential. Together it is known as a transmission system. So power from the produced from the engine, it has to transfer to the wheels. How you are going to transfer that power? That is using the transmission system. So we are depending upon the type of drive used in the automotive. Either it might be front wheel drive or might be rear wheel drive for the four wheelers. So clutch and gearbox varies with the leverages, that is ratio of torque output to the torque input. So that means whatever the engine torque is produced from the engine, that has to either reduce or increase depending upon the gear ratio. So propeller shaft, what it means, it transfers the final torque to the wheel. Whatever the torque has been produced from the gearbox, so that differential will transfers that gears equally to the wheels, that is the road wheel, driving wheel, either might be rear wheel or front wheel depending upon the types of drive we are going to use. So whenever you talk about a transmission system, it has to perform the following function, that is it has to disconnect engine from the driving wheel whenever it is required. So sometimes we need lower speed while running on the engine, sudden some disturbance may comes, so we need to reduce the speed. So we have to disconnect the engine from the driving wheels whenever it is required. That is the function of your transmission system. Then the other function is when the engine is connected to the driving wheels without jerking. So when disconnection is over, whenever it is connected back, you should not give any kind of jerk motion for the vehicle. Then the chain ratio of torque output to the torque input as desired, whenever you require how much amount of torque, it has to change. Then finally it has to close the drive through a right angle. Typically the clutch consists of a clutch fork, thrust bearing, diaphragm, cover pressure plate, clutch plate and a flywheel. These are the constituent of your clutch device. So function of clutch, what is the main function of your clutch? Whenever the clutch is engaged, power flows from the engine to the wheels, to the transmission system, and vehicle will moves. That is the engagement of the clutch. Whenever it is disengaged, power is not transmitted to the wheels. So vehicle will stop while engine is still running. That means whenever you clutch, you press or disengaging of the take place, that means power won't transmit, but engine is still, it will be on the on condition. The clutch is disengaged when starting of the engine, when shifting of the gears and stopping of the vehicle, and when idling of the engine. So these are the condition you can expect clutches to be in the disengaged position. Clutch is kept constant while engine is moving. So whatever the clutch pedal we are talking about in your vehicle, that is whenever you are not pressing, that means engine is in engaged with the transmission system and vehicle is moving. So whenever you press the clutch pedal, that means we are making the disengage from the engine to the transmission box, and whatever the required operation is required, that you have to do. Clutch also formates gradual takeoff of load. So it will take gradually whenever the clutch is operated. And also it will prevent the jerky motion of the vehicle. And various design requirement for the clutch. One is the torque transmission. So main objective is to transmit the torque from engine to the wheels through this clutch. Then it should be a transmission system. Then you have the gradual engagement. The clutch should not give any kind of jerk movement. So when it should gradually engage between the engine and the transmission system. And it is sufficient. That means it has to be transmitted. So whenever your clutch will be in operated position, there is a production due to friction, there will be, it will be produced. So that it has to be dissipated in the larger way, so that it has to keep in a proper condition. Then it has to give the balance, dynamically balance for the system. Then vibration should be avoided. So these are the design requirements for the clutch. Then clutch size should be as small as possible. This is very important because we will have a very narrow gap between the engine and your transmission system. So within that space constraint provided by the engine developers, you have to provide as small as possible so that it has to occupy the minimum space. So when designing that one, you have to take care of the size also. Another thing, free pedal play should be there. So in order to reduce the effective of clamping load on thrust bearing, then it should be in easy operation, should not be any more pressure for the drivers. Lightness, that means it should be as light as possible, or it should not carry much weight, so that fuel consumption might increase. So lightness should be very important factor. Then we will move on to the principle of clutches. Before that, different types of clutches we have. One is the frictional clutch, and one more is the fluid flywheel clutches. Fluid flywheel clutches. So frictional clutch means it is a either in this again we have the dry type and wet type. Dry type means a direct metal to metal contact, there won't be any fluid presence in the clutches, and wet type means there will be oil or fluid will be present inside the clutches. So in the dry type, it is directly the friction will comes into picture between two rotating elements. So coefficient of friction should be very less, very high in this dry type, but whereas in wet type, coefficient of friction is very less. Next, principle of operation. As you see this diagram, clutch plate A, B, C, D are represented over here, and W is the low. So what is the main working principle over here is whenever the two friction surfaces or two friction plate is brought in contact with each other. Due to coefficient of friction between them, whatever the one revolution will be there, one plate revolute, so that it will allow other plate to rotate in that same speed. So your coefficient of friction will comes into major role over here. We will try to understand this operation. So consider this shaft, which is termed as A, which will consist of disc B, so or plate B, and shaft C, which is connected to the disc D. So assume this disc B is rotating at a speed n rpm and D is stationary. So it is not moving, only B is moving with the speed of n rpm when clutch is not engaged position. So whenever there is no engagement between these two disc or this two shaft. So when application of axial force, whenever you pressing the pedal, so whenever you pressing the pedal or whenever the axial force is acted on this disc D, that is W force, this disc move towards the plate B and makes in contact with the it. So this frictional force between B and D causes power transmission between these two shafts. So whatever the power it is having, driving power we will call, it will given to the driven shaft. Driving member will be transfer the power to the driven shaft while contacting with each other. So D will also starts rotate, try to be the same speed whatever the B is having, with that speed only D will start also revolving. So this speed of D will depends upon the friction force between them, between them. So whatever the force, friction force is having, depends upon that it will having the speed of this D. So which will in turn having the how the applied force will be there. So depends upon that it will sell, it will rotate. So this clutch is said to be fully engaged when the speed of the B and speed of the D is becomes equal, then only we will call it as clutch is fully engaged. This is how we were working of friction clutches will be done. This is the working principle of your this only I told, just can go through this one. So over here the torque transmitted, it is given by T is nothing but mu times WR. Mu is nothing but coefficient of friction, W is the load and R is the radius. So it is given by T is the torque transmitted, mu is the coefficient of friction, W is the axial force and R is the effective mean radius of the friction surfaces. So by increasing any of these values will increase the torque. W is the ability of the driver to operate the clutch pedal without causing the strain. Usually this is limited to 90 to 130 Newton. So W is limited, R is fixed because it is designed such a way that R will be fixed. So only parameter is selection of material with the highest coefficient of friction, then torque transmission will be very high. So mu value should be high, so that your torque transmitted should be high from one plate to other or one shaft to the other. So this is how we are going to increase the torque. Different types of clutches. So type of clutches, as already we are told, friction clutches and So different types of clutches. We have the friction clutch and fluid fly clutch. So in the friction clutch, again wet pipe and dry pipe. So wet type, we have oil bath type. When the fluid comes in contact with the oil bath type, then it's called wet type. In the dry type, we have the dark clutches, cold clutches, single plate clutches, multi plate clutches, centrifugal clutches, and centrifugal clutches. So these are the things we are going to study over here. So first we will discuss about dark clutches. So dark clutches, you can see the diagram over here. So this is known as a positive type of clutch, positive type of clutch, which is used to connect two shaft or to connect the gate to the shaft. It consists of a sliding member which has having the internal teeth. So this contains sliding member which is having the internal teeth or internal splice and smaller diameter splines, rides on the splined shaft. So splined shaft and turns with it. So we have the splined shaft over here, it is there, which is in a smaller diameter. So sliding member having the internal teeth on the sliding shaft and larger internal splines which matches with the external teeth. External teeth also we will call it as dog clutch teeth, dog clutch teeth. So on the shaft or gear drive, it will be the gear shaft, we will call it as. When two are connected by the clutch action, usually dog clutches are used, usually this dog clutches are used for synchronizing mechanism. So this whatever the external teeth or internal teeth will be there, so this will be used for the synchronizing mechanism, and this clutches positively takes drive gradually. So what will happen, sir, in this case the slippage, what you will call, it will be avoided. So it will takes the gradually whatever the force applied gradually, and it will transmit the power. So it will fixes this both internal and external members will fixes with each other and takes the gradually transmit the load. So in this way the working of dog clutches are there. So this is the first time for your dry clutches. So example of this dog clutches can be found in a Sturm-Archer bicycle upgrade, where sliding cross shaped clutch is being used lock the driver assembly to different parts of planetary gate drive. So this is example where you can just check the dog clutches. So what are the advantage of this and disadvantage we will take care. So advantage is it will have the, when compared to other type of clutch, normal force on the friction surface area is greater than the axial force. So since the area is more, that will be the advantage for this type of clutch. But the disadvantage is difficult to disengage the clutch if that whatever the cone angle will be there. So cone angle, if it is less than 20 degree, because it can bind together, one cone material will bind together. So even a small amount of weight on the friction surface results in a more action moment of the cone. So these are the advantage and the disadvantage of this cone clutch. So this is how we will finish this topic today's class till cone clutch. So what are the things we studied is what you mean by clutch or what you mean by transmission system. From the transmission system, what are the components involved in it, then what you mean by clutch, what is the function of clutch. So while designing, what are the things you ought to consider, and different types of clutch. And in this different types, we studied two types of clutches. One is a dog clutches, one more is your cone clutches. So what are the advantages of this cone clutches and disadvantages? So this many things we have studied. So more importantly, while in this subject, important thing is the diagrams. Diagrams you have to do it properly and try to write point by point wise explanation. Don't write in a long story wise explanation. Write point to point explanation and underline the main important parameter over here. Any topic, if you select, you underline it or you make one box type, so that evaluator should look into that point, so that you can get maximum marks. So very easy, but make sure that this module is very lengthy, so you have to practice more and more figure. Don't confuse it. So day to day practice is required, so practice it in a better way. So today's class is going to complete. So next class we will study about single plate clutch and multi plate clutches in a deeper way.